Kabaka, glad you're watching The Business Show. Now, in case you're watching for the first time, this show airs every Thursdays at 10 p.m. We do have a repeat on Saturdays at 8 in the morning. So make a date with us and learn something about how to run your business. I keep saying I do not know where your business stands now in terms of how it's performing. But listen, if your business is struggling and you can see that, it is not good for you to keep pumping money in that business. Sometimes step back, act, let the expert act on your business, and it could just help you save that little other money that you still have that you think you need to continue pumping. Some people just enjoy putting more money in business, having stock, and they're not making any realistic returns. It is risky. Take time, study your business, and if it's not posting the profits and you've waited for a while, it's better you just step back and close it and, you know, try something. So, talking about closing and how to make money this week, this is a whole interesting conversation by Violet Kokunake of Nesting Farm Enterprises. She is based in Wakiso. I must say I was mesmerized. She abandoned a job of being, she was working in one of the biggest hospitals in this country. So she abandoned that job, and through 2013, she thought to herself, look, why don't I just move on and do something else? She went into poultry rearing. We're talking about 4,000 plus birds now. Listen, I have a whole conversation from her, and I just hope you can learn something from Violet, plus all the other different things that you need to know on how to run a poultry business that is successful, not just running a poultry business like some people. This is poultry business that is successful. From the numbers, when you listen to this conversation, you tell that yes, it is successful. This is how to make money this week.
Hello, I'm Violet Kokundakwe Mugerwa, the Managing Director of Nesting Farm Enterprises. This is mainly a commercial poultry farm where we rear hens for egg production. Our goal is to feed people with healthy and nutritious eggs. We also produce organic manure, and when the birds are old, we sell them for meat as off layers. We also produce hair oil from coconuts and garlic and ginger. It's very good for chasing dandruff, moisturizing the hair, and helping with itchy scalp. We produce juice that is safe, that is nutritious, from sugarcane, ginger, lemon, and molondo, and also mushrooms. Yeah, we do a lot.
Okay. Yeah. All right, Violet, thank you so much for allowing to speak to us. I must confess, from the time we walked in here, I was mesmerized by what I saw. Maybe for the benefit of our viewers, just tell us, you have 3,000 birds now.
Yes.
I know it didn't start with the 3,000.
No.
Please just talk to us about your journey.
We started in 2013, about March. I'm actually a medical radiographer by profession.
Okay.
I was working in one of the prominent hospitals in Uganda, and I resigned and started poultry farming. Why? My passion has always been farming. So we started with 250 birds and very little knowledge. So
about how much was that? 250
birds? 250 birds, about 5 million.
That's a lot of money in 2013.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I started with it just enough to buy the birds.
Mm-hmm.
The 5 million is cumulative over the period of the 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
But I started with just what I had to buy the birds and kept injecting slowly, slowly. Once it had peaked, that's when I left. I didn't just up and leave the job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so like I was saying, I started with more enthusiasm and little knowledge. So we faced a bit of challenges from management, because I didn't know what I was doing. But along the way we have learned, and here we are now with 3,000 birds. We've actually hit 4,000.
Okay.
In COVID we had to offlay, but now we are back. we are pushing on.
Okay. So your story is going to be quite interesting because for most people, businesses are started as, you know, I don't have anything, but I have some money. Now for you, you had a job and you chose to leave what you started for. Mm. Was it about the money or the passion? And you talk about challenges. How are you able to then, you know, maneuver to get to this point now?
I'd say both. I can't say it was just the passion or just the money. I've always wanted to be rich. If you have a job, your job will give you a salary until a certain level, yeah? So I had actually gone for a master's in the University of Johannesburg, but I looked at the prospects of going up the ladder. They were really slim. Mm-hmm. And business is what I saw as an opportunity to give me what I wanted in terms of financial freedom. Mm. So yeah, that's coupled with a passion. Now where the passion comes in is that with, like I've said, I've faced so many challenges. Okay. I could have given up.
Yeah.
But that's where the passion comes in. It keeps you going where you expected to go and get money. You're getting beaten, but you're staying because I know I want to be very successful.
Yeah.
I love poultry, I love farming. It calms me down that even when it's supposed to be stressful for someone else, it's not that to me. So okay. Yeah, that's a passion and the desire to be better.
All right, so for someone watching, the question then would be, so you started this business while you kept your other job. How did you balance that?
It was challenging, but you do what you have to do. I would wake up very early, clean for the birds, put in food. I didn't have an employee. You can't get someone to take care of those birds when you have little money. Mm. So I'd get up very early, even my family would help me, and then go to work, then come back, clean up after, and the cycle continues.
Yeah.
Until the number grew, then you can employ someone. Otherwise, you're eating profit you don't have putting an employee.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you talk about employing people. I know we'll talk about that later because I've seen you have some people that work for you.
Yes.
Now. So 2013 we've started and then you choose to leave your job.
Mm.
And then now focus on this. So talk to us about then, how do you maintain your schedule? Because then I imagined, you know, when you work for people, there's what works for you. And then there are systems. How do you handle this business knowing that at the end of the day, I am the boss anyway?
If you're not self-disciplined, the results are evident. You can't grow.
Mm.
Actually, it's good that I was employed for those times.
Mm.
I resigned my work to work with patients in 2013, but I kept on my job. I was also teaching in Mulago. So I kept that on until 2019 is when I stopped the teaching. But it teaches you that you must get up. You must have a timetable. If you wake up late, the birds won't eat enough. If they don't eat enough, they're not going to lay.
Mm.
If they don't lay, you don't have money. So them alone, they push you to be disciplined.
Mm.
But if you relax, I actually learned it from, I think he's BMK or one of the big guys who are into poultry. He said, if you wake up past 5, forget the poultry business. If you wake up after 5, forget the poultry business. They are very disciplined creatures that they themselves alone will discipline you.
Yeah.
Yes.
So people say business is not for the faint-hearted. What's your experience?
It's true. It's true. It's not. There are a number of challenges.
Hmm.
Without discipline, you can't make it. Without perseverance, you can't make it. Without consistency, you can't make it. Without bravery, you can't make it. Without passion, there's a lot that goes into being successful. Unless you just want to do what you're doing as a hobby, which is also fine. But if you're doing it to make money,
yeah,
it really, you have to put in the grind, you have to work hard, and you have to work smart also, because there's for just working, you see some Ugandans are very hard working.
That's right.
But few will put in the extra smart of, are you keeping your books, records? Are you taking financial literacy classes? Or are you spending all that you're making?
Yeah.
And therefore becoming broker.
Than you started. Yeah.
Yeah. Really, it's not for the faint-hearted, but with discipline, perseverance, consistency, you make it.
You mentioned issues of bookkeeping, and it's probably something I'll ask a little later. But let's talk about, so you did have the skills, but you started. So where did you pick up from there then?
So what happened is I visited my cousin's farm. You know, you visit people, you get it, like someone will listen to this story and you get inspired. Quickly, you start. Hey! You start like this, do like this, put in food, you know. It seems easy. Then you go to, how do we make the money?
Yes, because you have the birds whatever, but how do you actually make the money?
So I visited my cousin's farm. I was excited and he was doing so well. So I was inspired. But I didn't sit even for a second to think what are the challenges he's facing. I didn't even ask him. I just ran.
Picked 5 million.
And started. Actually borrowed.
That's another part of it.
Borrowed 5 million.
Was it a good idea?
No, I don't advise it. Start with what you have and grow slowly. It was not a good idea to borrow. So, but that's what happened. I wish, in hindsight, I had known at least the basics of how to manage the poultry. But I am also grateful to him that I kept him, and for that wisdom to keep him as a mentor. You know, sometimes you can go and start and think all is well.
Yeah.
But I kept him and I would constantly call him, ah, my friend, this is going bad. Or today they look like this, they are dying. I lost more than half of them.
Oh dear.
Yes, that first lot. But now I know what to do and how to prevent. Actually, right now we practice preventive management.
Okay.
In that we take months and months without putting antibiotics in our birds.
Mm-hmm.
So we produce an antibiotic-free egg that is very safe for human consumption.
Okay.
And that's what we pride ourselves in.
All right. So let's talk about people that jump onto businesses like you. Most of them, you know what, after 6 months or 3 months, they're like, "Kusasula just to rent." Now, like, we don't know where to go from here. I know it's too soon, but what would be your advice for people that think it is about, I don't have work to do, but I have some money, let me just start a business?
It's not wise, but once you've started and someone has assured you that the business is profitable, find ways of making it profitable. If it's working for someone, for example, in my case, I almost gave up. But I'm one person. I don't keep quiet with my problem.
Yeah.
I share. So I keep talking. I talked to a certain lady where I used to buy food from, and she was like, "But Viola, the problem is you. There are women who have less birds than you." By that time I had reached 1,000 birds, but they were stressing me. I would put in money and then you sell off layers, and the money you've gotten from off laying is the one that is what is keeping the birds.
Yeah.
She was like, "Viola, there are women who have 500 birds and they pay tuition for their children in university. Then I didn't even have children." So she was like, "The issue is you." And indeed it was me. So I went back and started thinking, what is wrong? I eventually landed on a certain gentleman. He's one of my other mentors.
Yeah.
He's in Nansana, the owners of Mug Ranch in Nansana. He's called Mr. Tony and his brother Michael. He calculated for me in detail, told me, "Do this, he told me, "Sell everything, we're going to start afresh." I sold everything and followed to the letter what he told me. And here I am today, very profitable. So do not give up. If you know, they have told you that it is profitable. If someone has told you selling matoke is profitable and you have tried it and it is not working out for you, there is a problem with what you are doing along the way. Maybe you're getting the money and you're not keeping because you don't know. You know, sometimes whatever money comes is what you spend. You spend, you're not budgeting. I'm giving what I was doing. You're not budgeting. Whatever comes, you, the child asks, we want this.
You buy. Dress, shoes, bags.
Now, at the end of the day, the business is looking at you. You're looking at the business. But if someone has told you it works, it is legal.
Yes, that's the other thing.
Find ways of making it work.
So, one of the things is, I know people despise businesses. For someone be watching and say, so that pretty woman chose to do poultry, like me, degree poultry, like seriously?
For me, as long as it is legal, profitable, I will do.
Do you have a life?
Yeah. And I enjoy it thoroughly. I do.
You have time off for, I am done with work now. It is.
Yes. See, as long as you do things the right way, you put in place systems. Obviously, you know, sometimes people think to have a life is to party 24/7. That's not a life. Because you're going to look down the road when you're 50 and you can no longer party. You don't have the money to spend even then. That's not life. But if I can spend time, like for example now, I proud myself in being a stay-at-home mom.
That's a nice one.
Yeah. I stay at home.
Yeah.
I'm an agricultural entrepreneur and I'm a mom. I take my child to a school nearby. It is affordable with regards to what we earn.
Yeah.
I have time with my baby. When my other child comes home, finds me at home. I am in close proximity. I don't have to trek to work every day. It is less stressful for me. That's the life that I want, really. I think I'm living a good life.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So most people across this country do poultry. So what makes you unique?
What makes me unique? I told you, we pride ourselves in producing eggs that are antibiotic free, that are clean. I don't think many farmers can say that.
I've seen some.
We clean, we keep this place clean, we mist. Misting what we sprayed you. We spray the whole house once a week. We take out the manure twice a week. We flush these once or twice a month, the water pipes, to ensure that there's no salmonella, the bird is not going to get enteritis, gastritis. So we're not going to have to put in antibiotics anyhow. So if you get an egg from our farm, you know you're getting a safe egg, which very few people can pride in. Another thing that I'm very proud of, we are here post-COVID.
In our quest to keep giving you the best that you need, we're down in Wakiso. And this is particularly to help you understand that whereas you're struggling, there are people that are successful. And it's important that you use such basics from other people and, you know, learn one or two things on how you can improve your business. Things like, are your birds treated on time? Are they fed well? Are they separated from dirt? Things like that are very important for you planning to do any business. How do you treat your employees? Sometimes we say things like, well, they're successful because maybe they are connected. But listen, on how many times have you had money or have you known people that have money and have failed to succeed in business? I keep saying it is not entirely about money. Sometimes there are basic things you need to pay keen attention to if you're going to break through with your business. Okay, so I hope you've learned something in part one of our conversation with Violet. Next week, we'll be talking something else, still on her farm. So make a date with us and learn how to make that money. Good. So let's talk then how to run your business. This is now personal finance, but this week I just thought, okay, we've been giving tips on how to manage finances, but how about we talk about how to manage your business, okay? Because, listen, on several times you ask people, who are your customers? And they will tell you, well, for me, anyone that walks in, I will sell to them. That in itself is risky, because every day you wake up, you need to understand that my business targets people from 18 to 35, 40 to 80, something like that. In that then, you'll be able to know that when I'm restocking, I am getting products particularly for this age bracket, and this group of people will buy these things around this time. Otherwise, if you are a general person, I am not saying don't go general. I am just saying you have an extra niche if you choose to segment on your customers. And that is what we're looking at this week, on personal finance. Like I said, we are looking at how to improve your business. So we are talking why you need customer segmentation in your business. This week, we share with you tips on why you need customer segmentation in your business. One, you will be able to meet your customers' needs and expectations since you have a clear picture of who they are and what they want, hence improving customer satisfaction. Customer segmentation promotes expansion of new products and services that are relevant to your customers. This is mainly because you already have a better understanding of the stuff that your clients might be interested in. 3. It often leads to customer loyalty and retention. Here, you are able to look out for the top buying clients and create for them personalized offers, e.g. gifts. 4. It helps in proper pricing since you have data on the social and financial status of the customers. Here, you are in a better position to determine an appropriate pricing policy. It helps in designing customized sales and marketing campaigns directly targeting your clients. Market segmentation also promotes product and service differentiation. This is especially key in a highly competitive market environment where there are many similar products and services on offer. And finally, when you segment, you can channel all your efforts on a specific group of customers and aim at offering them a unique experience. So it's no doubt, there's no doubt that when you segment, you focus your attention on the clients that matter. Remember what I said at the start of the show, you don't sell your goods to anyone that looks like they want it. You sell your goods to people that are interested. That way you have less stress and your business will move because you are dealing with a particular market audience or target audience that you know in the market, not everyone that walks past your business. Time now for Forex and Money Market Report. I guess that's it on the program this week. Thank you so much for making time and listening to us or watching us from wherever you are. We hope you learned something about how to manage your business. In case you want to get back to us, our socials are right below your screen. Let us know what you think about the program or what you need to be helped on. We'll be more than glad to respond. Part 2, 3, 4 and the rest of Violet's conversation on poultry business and mushroom growing will be coming through in the subsequent week. So make a date with us and learn something. My name is Simon. For me and the rest of the team, is you take care of yourselves. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.